Well, good evening and welcome to Tucker Carlson Tonight. In about an hour from now, President Trump will address the country to explain what we ought to do next in Afghanistan. The White House has indicated the president will ask for several thousand more American service members to be sent to that country. If he does, he'll be the third president in a row to suggest a troop surge in Afghanistan in what has become the longest war in our history. We'll wait to hear the details, of course, but in the meantime, here are a few obvious questions. First, what is our objective in Afghanistan? Victory, of course, but what does that mean? American troops have been there for 16 years, in part because there is no consensus on what winning is. If the measure is defeating the Taliban, how will we know when they are finally beaten? If our goal is to create a stable democracy, how stable is stable enough? If we like to see a secular, modernized, economically prosperous Afghanistan, and that was the goal at one point, are we really certain that's possible in the next 50 years, if ever? Second, if we increase our presence in Afghanistan, what long-term U.S. interest are we pursuing by doing that? The original goal was to eliminate state-sponsored terrorist training camps. Those are long gone. Even if those camps came back, it's not clear how relevant they would be. Islamists now recruit on the internet, and even an untrained extremist can kill dozens with a car. We've learned that sad lesson recently. So what is the point of this? If the goal is simply to keep Islamic extremism from our shores, why is a war in Afghanistan more effective than, say, a vigorously enforced travel ban? Third, how will this strategy dramatically improve what we've been doing in Afghanistan already for a decade and a half, a policy that clearly hasn't worked? How do we ensure that President Trump's successor doesn't have to give another speech like this 4 or 8 years from now? And finally, how much are we willing to pay to achieve these goals? We've already spent over $1 trillion in Afghanistan. More than 3,500 American service members and civilian contractors have died there. More troops inevitably will mean more deaths and billions more in money we don't have. Is it worth it? If we send 5,000 troops to Afghanistan and that strategy fails, will we cut our losses and leave as the Soviets and the British did before us? Will we send another 5,000, 10,000, 50,000? What is Afghanistan worth to us? It might be worth thinking through that ahead of time.